Last week I went over both Overlight and Coyote and Crow, two games with relatively eh systems, with one critical flaw by having very subpar settings to base everything around. So I wanted to not necessarily fix them, but more provide something of an alternative. A what if you will. The first one we'll be talking about is actually Overlight, or the magic monkey game with seven floating sky continents, which seem really cool, right? However, here's the major issue, there isn't actually much meat to anything. The actual setting detailing each of the seven shards is rather sparse, with all the folk needing their time in the sun and needing special mechanics for each, not to mention the Skyborn themselves being the special OC Ubermensch with actually not a lot on them in the core book. So what's the proposed change? Well, there's two of them. The first is an entire refocus on the game Zenith Order, perhaps best known folk out of all of them due to the Hunmanu. The Zenith Order is quite literally an entire group of warrior monks tasked with fighting ethereal nightmare moths and our humans bonded with Hunmanu in literal mind and spirit, as they are literally trying to return to monkey. Now picture this. The entire game is now focused on a group of traveling monks. You're effectively a mixture of divine pest control and guardians of order and chromatic superheroes. Your constant companion is a Hunmanu, meaning a group will always need to be in groups of 2, 4, and 6, but the system is light enough to actually accommodate larger groups pretty easily. You're a traveling exorcism party in more than a few ways. Work in some basic mechanics for exorcism, using your chroma powers as a method to deal with spiritual threats, and bam, you have something pretty interesting. But traveling monks. Exploring the world is partially your duty and recording the mysterious world around you. Now, option B is lean on the Skyborn more, as you're effectively the magical cops in this world. People blessed by Mega God with superpowers and the associated issues of such. With that issue, you have to deal with the various layers and their bullshit. However, this is the controversial opinion, make it so you can only be human. That's their one gimmick over every other foe. They can have the magic chroma powers, and they can't. However, there are already three human folk in this setting, the Zenith Monks, Harakin, and Arumel, so that there are already plenty to work with. You're part explorer, part humanitarian assistance in a weird and funky world. Cut out a lot of the funky stuff, actually, and replace it in the background. Focus more on the magical nature of the world through very human eyes and the associated issues. Now, this may seem as the cutting more than adding, but arguably I am, but instead of 8 or 9 pages for each shard, there should be 12 15, give us detail, let us explore those individual places and experience them through human eyes. Playing a Binyari is neat, but playing a Skyborn Binyari from Banyan who's currently exploring Herrick with my Harakin and Arumel companions loses a bit of something when you care so little about any one of those due to the lack of actual meat to any individual story. Next is Coyote and Crow. Now, the consortium and I joked about some of the nature of the setting, but there were two major things that caught our eye about Mr. Alexander's wild ride, which fascinated us as a maybe. The first was more of a primal survival game. Imagine, if you will, a game during the heart of the freezing apocalypse. Your people have migrated south in hopes of survival, abandoning ancestral land in favor of the off chance of actually living. You've adopted others, you've fought others, but then our story takes place. It's an odyssey from A to B, moving through your now nomadic people in freezing temperatures while keeping yourself alive. Worse yet, this apocalypse is more than just an endless winter. Something is in the woods. Every crunch of snow underfoot is equal parts desperation and fear of that half-second delay of the noise behind you. Something is in the woods and you're on the menu. You have to manage this mystical survival aspect combined with the raw desperation of people. Depending on your tribe of amalgamation of tribes, small bonuses and penalties can apply to your struggle or die in the snow like dozens of others. Alternatively, if you want a more settled game, you can sit in your homes in relative safety, but the only thing worse than a new cold spell is the hordes of other people coming down south fully intending to survive, even if you don't. This should be more of an emphasis on the tribal identities and cultural practices of hundreds of different people in an extreme and exotic situation, which the system could technically kind of handle. It'd allow to fully remove some of the goddamn cyberpunk elements which make zero fucking sense in that game and will never make sense. Now, the alternative is a variety of interesting settings in the other parts of the world, such as Crossing Crescent. At the end of the days come close, the most temperate and ideal climate would probably be the Mediterranean. Now picture a mass migration of starving peasants and knights streaming into the now starting Renaissance Italy, Spain, and the Balkans. Where do you send these starving, desperate, and very holy? Crusading, of course, for the territories of Northern Africa under, quote, Muslim rule, which should be read as just please God get out of Italy, we're all dying here. All the while, the proud city of Constantinople would most likely fall far quicker due to half the empire currently being on fire and being eaten, all while the sultans of the Ottoman Empire reign supreme, if only doing having the ideal land and relative stability. Now flash forward, now you have neo-crusaders and cyberpunk janissaries dueling in the open waters as the forces of the Holy See and Ottoman crown clash for supremacy. God, now imagine what's going on in India, Southeast Asia, hell, even China. Remember, everyone's got fucking magic in this as well. It may even be interesting to look at, but we ended up with kind of a half-baked setting in North America, a idea that was just kind of hodgepodge thrown together, which is a shame. I made this video not as a diss track against Coyote and Crow or Overlight, but more of how a setting can drastically influence a game in its design. What would Overlight look like if you were entirely just Zenith monks with a companion, an entire game built around a mutual partnership? What if Coyote and Crow had to factor in cyberpunk hand cannons of an Aga dueling a crusader in the open seas of the goddamn Med? It's easy to think of a setting as just as a background sometimes to a system, but even small details can have a pretty large impact on the nature of the game being presented and played. My name is Notepad Anon, and this was my rambling at 4 in the morning. If you like what I do here, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. And many thanks to the plutocrats as always. Thank you, and good night.